Hi, welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, my name is Kayla. I make videos all about DIY projects. Today, what we're going to talk about are five big things that you could be doing wrong when making a DIY concrete vessel for either a planter or for candles. So don't forget to subscribe so you can see all the new videos I come up with in the future. Let's jump into it. All right, so the first thing we're gonna talk about is the actual concrete that you're using to make the containers. When I first started, I used cement and it was Quikrete. So when I first made my containers, I squeezed it and it broke. I didn't even squeeze it very hard. So what you wanna do is find a mix that has some additives in it. So for example, I used cement all. I know it's a little deceiving because of the name, but it is concrete. It has some sand in it as well, and it makes it stronger. From my testing, I personally love cementol. I'm sticking with cementol. If something else comes out, I might try it. I have heard other people using other things, but when you're searching for concrete to use, just make sure that it does say concrete and not just cement. Now, along with talking of the type of concrete that you want to use, you also want to make sure that you're using the right ratio. This is the number one problem that I see people making with making these concrete containers. So with cement all, you definitely want to use a 4-to-1 ratio. I have heard that other concretes are similar, but you also want to do your own testing. But the 4-to-1 ratio, meaning 4 parts concrete, 1 part water. Now, if you see maybe like a pool of water at the top of the mold after you pour, you probably have poured too much water or you didn't stir enough. So when you're stirring the concrete, you wanna stir a lot. I stir one way and then the other way for a good 3 to 4 minutes. You really want the water to mix into the concrete, and that also helps release any air bubbles that may come up. Now on that note, if you do not add enough water, it's going to be very thick. So the best consistency when doing a 4-to-1 ratio would be like pancake consistency. So not too runny, not too thick to where you can still pour it into the container nicely. All right, so the second problem that I see a lot of people doing, and also what I used to do or what I didn't do, was tapping the molds. So after you pour your concrete, you want to be tapping that mold to release all those air bubbles. So personally, what I do, if you've seen any of my videos, I will go ahead and just tap the sides. So I'll pour, you know, maybe a quarter or a half into the mold, tap the sides, drop it on the table a little bit to allow the concrete to set, and then I'll go ahead and pour the rest of it and then tap it. I do tap the mold for a good few minutes after pouring, just to make sure that if any air bubbles are at the bottom, those are all released. If you don't do this, you will end up with a container that just has little holes on the outside, or you could end up with a container with a big hole on the outside. So tapping the molds is very, very important. I have seen people buy vibrating pads or, you know, maybe like a sander that they can put onto the table to vibrate the molds for them. That is absolutely an option. Me personally, I just go ahead and tap the molds. All right, so to give you an idea of what the container would look like if you didn't tap the sides of the mold, this is what it would look like. So if you're looking for a nice soft finish on the containers, you want to make sure you're tapping. Now, if you like this hole look, which I've seen a lot of candles with this look, then don't tap and it'll add some character to your container. But if you're looking for this soft look, which I know a lot of us are trying to do, make sure you're tapping your molds after you pour the concrete. All right, so the third thing I'd like to talk to you today about is to make sure you're allowing your molds to set after you pour. So it's very important to allow them some time to cure in the mold before you remove the mold. So if you try to remove that mold before it's ready, it will make dents in the container, it won't come out right, it could break. You wanna make sure you're allowing enough time for it to set in the mold. Me personally, I do a minimum of 3 to 4 hours. So usually I let mine set, like if I make a candle at night, I would let it set overnight. Sometimes I make my candle containers in the morning and I won't take them out until 4 hours. Sometimes three, if I'm trying to make a lot at one time. Now, after I take my containers out of the mold, I do allow it to set a little bit as well before I put the sealant on. So when you take your container out of the mold, it will be a little wet and a little cold, depending on where you're at. So you wanna let that set before putting any sealant on it or pouring anything in it or putting anything in it. Just let it set for a few hours. Some people let it set for a day or two and then put your sealant on. Again, you just wanna test. Just test, 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 and that will tell you your perfect combination because everyone uses something different. You know, you could use a different sealer, you could use different concrete. So just make sure you're testing, but I would always let it set a little bit longer than what you expect or what you're wanting. I know it's very hard. I love taking my containers out and it's so exciting to take them out, but it is very beneficial to wait. All right, so the fourth thing that I'd like to talk to you today is about coloring the concrete. So I get a lot of questions on my YouTube channel, my Facebook, my Instagram about how I color the concrete. So currently right now I use acrylic paint. So I just use regular acrylic paint. I don't use the satin finish or anything. I have found personally when I use the satin finish, it really soaks up into the concrete and it's really hard to stir. So I would recommend just regular acrylic paint. I love it because it comes in so many different colors and I can be really creative with it. Now I have tried powder before, but I only tried from one company. So the powder I did try before didn't really work for me. I preferred the acrylic paint. However, I did just purchase concrete pigment from a different company and I'm actually gonna be testing it out next week and I'm gonna be making a video for it. So be sure to subscribe to my channel so that way you can be notified when I post that next week and you can see how that works out. On that note of coloring the concrete, you definitely wanna make sure that you're adding a little bit at a time. There is what I call a max shade. So what that means is when you're pouring, for example, say we're pouring this teal into the concrete and I'm just adding a little bit at a time, there comes a point where you can't add any more paint to change the color. So there's a max shade that the concrete will get and adding more paint is not gonna change the color. It's actually going to make the container weaker. So if you think about if you add too much paint to the container ratio with the concrete and the water, you don't want too much paint in there because then there's not enough concrete to keep it strong. So what I usually do, again, just add a little bit at a time. And then once you get to that shade, you can stop. You will notice after a while that the color doesn't change. And usually you're at your max shade at that point. So the fifth problem that I see a lot of people doing, and I did this myself as well, is just getting too excited and not doing your testing. So when I first started making candles 6 years ago, I made them in glasses and tins and I knew test your candles in those containers. Well, it's just as important testing your candles in concrete containers. In my opinion, I think it's more important just because you made that container. You don't know how that container is going to react with that candle. At least with glass or tin, you know, for the most part, it's pretty sturdy and pretty capable of holding a candle. Your concrete container, you need to make sure that that is capable of holding a candle and also allowing that candle to burn all the way through. Some things that you might run across are cracking, seeping, meaning you might see the wax seep through the concrete container. When this happens, I would highly recommend doing maybe like a second sealant coat in the inside of the candle. Sometimes I do two coats. Just depends on, you know, how that first coat goes on. I am starting to do two coats on the inside of my vessels now just for that extra protection. So that is completely your call, but again, test, test, test. This is the most important thing you can do. You wanna test your wicks in your containers. You wanna test, you know, the seeping, making sure that the wax isn't seeping through. And also what I would do is after you make your first couple containers and you feel like you got your formula down, go ahead and squeeze it a little bit. That's what I did to my first container, and if I didn't do that, I wouldn't have known that the cement was not strong. So I can grab my containers now and squeeze them, and they don't break. But with my cement, I would squeeze it, and it would literally just snap. So that's another thing that you can test, you know, the durability of the container. Just make sure that you're always testing your items before you're shipping them out to customers, just to make sure that they're high quality. All right, so those are the five problems that I have personally seen people having, or also that I have done myself. I hope that this video helped you, and I am super excited for you guys to try out these concrete containers if you haven't already. If you have any questions at all, please feel free to post them in the comment section below, and I will get back to you. And as always, thank you again for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, because I will be posting new videos weekly. I'll see you in the next video.